I don't know about you, but do you feel like the MLOps topic is now like being shadowed by Gen AI and LLMs? Like every day you see a lot of stories, articles about this area, but less and less about MLOps anymore. I don't know. How do you feel about that?
Okay. I don't know whether the absolute number is less, but definitely... Definitely, there are a lot of topics around sometimes people call it LLM ops.
Yeah. Yes.
Right. I think it is very close and should be very close. I also believe that MLOps is close to DevOps, but it is another story. I just think that we are like. And I think the relation is quite similar. We have some good practices around DevOps. MLOps workflows brought new requirements, new needs. So I prefer to think about it that we expanded DevOps to and called it MLOps. But okay, maybe we've built MLOps looking at DevOps. Philosophical discussion. I think that with large language models and LLMOps, it will be actually pretty close, and we would quite likely we will need to add another support of another use cases, way of working, way of testing. But I definitely think that large language models will work next to deep learning models. Maybe via agents, but in many, many use cases, practical use cases, business use cases, you won't solve them just with large language model. And you will be combining those techniques.
I agree. I think they will complement each other in terms of these large language model. And regarding to LLMOps and MLOps, I agree with you. I think it's just another layer on top of MLOps. We could brand it LLMOps or not, but they are related. But there are also some uniqueness to working with LLM as well. So that will be an exciting piece moving forward.
You know, like, for instance, when we discuss product roadmap, we also think about personas, like people who will be using our tool. I think like we acknowledge that we should include, I even heard the term AI engineer now. Yes. So it's kind of close to software engineer, but with understanding of basic understanding of machine learning, basic understanding of testing, but an engineer that builds, again, not a model, it's not a person who would do fine tuning of open source model, but a person who would be writing prompts with agents and try to build a software that is using LLM. So, yeah, we'll see. Right now, we are introducing basics, like basic building blocks that helps you visualize and debug prompts and traces. Talk with our customers, talk with our users. There are we have a lot of data scientists who were also asked by management. I think it is why Arimas brought this question. How did it start at Dardosh? I'm talking about large language models, because very often, based on what we hear, the very first team that is being asked to explore large language models is data science team. Even though, if you just want to use, let's say, OpenAI hosted model, do you need to be data scientist? Not really, right?